There we go again. Jablan Khumalo uthi Jacob Zuma, he doesn't even think. Another thing that he mentions is the fact that Floyd Shivambo has came to EMK party to steal the party. Jacob Zuma is, he can't think. Jacob, yes, I'm sitting here, I'm thinking to myself, it's one thing to diss somebody. It's one thing to dislike somebody. It's one thing to belittle somebody. But how you do it, I mean, come on, it must make sense. You know what I'm saying? Do not sound like a bitter ex. Whatever you say, do not sound like a bitter ex. You know, I would have understood if Jablan was talking about maybe how things were running and giving more insight about those things. But listening to Jablan, Jemina, I couldn't find any insight from what Jablan has said, Jablan Khumalo said. I just kind of felt like, MJ, nah, I disagree with you. I disagree with you. You're going to listen to Loku Jablan. I'm going to place those videos soon. But I disagree with the man because the facts that that is bringing on the table does not make sense at all. They don't make sense. All of them, they don't make sense at all, right? At least if he had told us something that does make sense, then, I can... facts are facts at the end of the day. We can't debate facts. We just cannot debate facts. Because facts are facts and facts does not change. With that being said, let's listen to the first video where he was saying, Jacob Zuma doesn't think here.
This is the craziness of Jacob Zuma. He doesn't think. He just do things as he wishes. Because people say, Baba, that is a very big problem that we have in Nkondo Esizwe. Because Nkondo Esizwe is not going forward because people will tell you, Baba is sleeping, Baba is tired, Baba is this. And we've missed all the things that the South African voters, they voted Nkondo Esizwe to lead in KZN. But we are not leading in KZN today because Zuma was sleeping. When the other parties were working towards getting the parliamentarians to work. In KZN, we should be leading. We should be having a premier. We're not having a premier. I don't know what is called now. In the national, we're supposed to be part of the government in whatever way, because the people voted to say, go to parliament and deal with our issues. People did not say, go to parliament and make mockery of us. What you see now is mockery. People that are in there, they will tell you, Ubaba, it's not right. So people who are parliamentarians that have been sent out are the very people that made the MK to be in parliament. Those people who are checking out these people, they were not even there to assist the organization to get into parliament. But because they are so-called chomies of Zuma's daughter, They have now taken over and they're doing as they please and they tell Zuma what to do. And Zuma doesn't say anything. He just say, okay, then he's like, they were chucked out for nothing.
Okay, now moving forward, usitshelile ngithi ukuthi Jacob Zuma doesn't think. So we have to accept that Jacob Zuma doesn't think. That's what he said. But another problem that I have with the statement, Jacob Zuma, we know Jacob Zuma, right? A lot of people who have been with Jacob Zuma will tell you that Jacob Zuma is a smart operator. So this thing of Jacob Zuma who doesn't think, where is it coming from? You know, you can discredit Jacob Zuma. We get it. You know, you can say whatever you want to say. But let that discredit be based on facts so that we can at least... follow you in whatever you want to say. At least we can get something from whatever you are saying, but it cannot be factless, and we are expected to believe it, because if we don't, we will be labeled the other way around. No, man, guys. It's like I always say, you can't be my enemy. I can't be you can't be my opposition. But I'm expecting you to give me a bit of a competition, man. You know what I'm saying? Give me something. Give me a bit of a competition. That's at least something that will convince me that, yeah, you know what? You are my opposition, but wow, you've got a competition. But before I can give you the next video, good people, I also first want us to deal with this issue here. If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people, because to subscribe, it is free. To like the video, it is free. To comment in the comment section below, it is free of charge. To click the notification bell, it is free of charge. To share this video, it is free of charge. To watch this video until the end, it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads, it's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed. Remember I said to you guys, according to this man, Ufloy Chivambo came to steal Gui MK Party, and now MK Party will be stolen. MK Party, Jacob Zuma is being misled by Duduzile Zuma. At least that's not what I'm saying. That is what the man is saying, that it's being misled by Duduzile Zuma. You know, it's going to end in tears. Don't ask me. Don't come for me. It's what the man says here. He says, Jacob Zuma is being misled right now. And you can't even... I'm not saying it's not true, but... some things are very difficult to believe, guys, because they are not based on... There's no facts that are being brought on the table. You don't want to sound like a bitter ex, and that's what I'm trying to avoid. You don't want to sound like a bitter ex. And now I want to listen to what Jay is saying here, and may probably find insights or facts. But truth be told, I find nothing here. Like, there's nothing that is convincing. Take a look at what he said about Floyd Chivambo here.
I don't think Floyd left EFF. Floyd started EFF. EFF is where it is because of Floyd and Malema. I don't believe, even in my sleep, that Floyd and Malema will ever be splitted. This could be orchestrated for us to be fooled and to lose the MK without knowing. But it's up to Zuma. If he does think he's got intelligence, he should be using his intelligence, because he'll always lie to us and say he's got intelligence. Intelligence is telling him what. But so many things has gone wrong in the MK under the nose of those so-called his intelligence. But for Chivambo to come to MK, there is something fishy about it. And I don't believe he came in just to assist MK or because he's got something against Malema. They've been working very well together.
Okay. So with the issue of Floyd Chivambo coming to steal MK coming to steal the actual party, that's according to the allegation. I'm saying to say, guys, We want to believe you, maybe, but give us something to believe, though, if we have to believe you. So far, there's no substantial evidence that we can base our faith on. Literally, there's nothing. Yes, we get it. the arrival of Floyd Shivambo. We get it. But is there any substantial evidence where we can base our faith on and say, yeah, Mara, he's making sense because of this? Nothing. I was listening to this whole thing. Nothing. So what must I say? Must I say because Jablan Khumalo said it, therefore it must be the truth? We are factual. We are people who stand on facts. Let me just say so. So, man. I kind of feel like I'm listening to a bitter ex, to be specific, who is just... it's kind of like I'm listening to a bitter ex. Let me just say so. Like I said, give me something, man. Let me work on. Give me something to work on. Give me some facts and say, you know what? This is the reason I'm saying this. Look at 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 that. Then at least it makes sense to. You're giving me something to think about, something to work on. But MJ has not provided anything. He's just there telling us, he's just telling us the way this is not going to succeed. We get it. A lot of people told us that MK Party was just going to be one of the smallest of the smallest party. But today, MK Party is the official opposition party in South Africa. So it's very difficult to listen to people without facts. It's just very difficult. For me, at least, maybe others can, but for me, I find it very strange that I can listen to you talking to me, telling me you, but you don't even have facts. Why am I even bothering myself listening to a person who doesn't even provide facts? I've not had facts listening to Lokuchablan Khumalo. At least when Julius Malema was telling us about how ANC is, they are very good in propaganda, he pointed things such as June 16 and all the stuff and showed us something that we did not know. And then it's easy to believe him because he's pointing facts. But MJ is just telling us things without facts. Come on, man. Come on. I find it very difficult to believe the man.